Since the recent expansion of FSD beta, we're starting to see a lot more videos come out. People who already have YouTube channels, people who don't, people want to share their experiences, and for good reason. Number one, this is exciting stuff. The car is driving for you for the most part. You still have to be attentive and you have to make sure you're in safe situations. But again, for the most part, the car is making left turns for you, right turns, it's stopping, it's making decisions in front of your very eyes. And that is exciting. It's an exciting time and an exciting thing to be a part of. So of course, people are going to want to share that experience. So yeah, I could look at it one way and say, you know, I don't need to contribute because there's just so much out there, it's so saturated. But at the same time, as someone who's had a YouTube channel for several years or a couple of years, I feel as though it's, you know, I'd like to share my experience, and there are probably people who want to see that. So that's what I'm doing this for. Am I going to be releasing a video every day? Of course not. But I do plan on, any time I do driving the car, recording it. And I'm going to kind of put that in my bag of videos, and we'll kind of go through some of the things that I've gone through. Now, what I did so far is, once I got FSD beta, I shared with you my first experience driving to work. And it did create, there is one part that raised a lot of eyebrows, and that was the fact that I went through a red light. So I kept reiterating the fact that it was safe, and I want to reiterate that one more time. But I want to start this video with that intersection, because I wanted to see how it would react with traffic on the roadway. So let's get right into it. And so this is the road that turns left and then getting kind of runs parallel to that road. So you'll see the stop sign here. Now, right off the bat, I didn't think there'd be any problems at the stop sign. It was going to turn left and then I would start to move on from there. But unfortunately, there is a car to my right that I was a little, because see how it's still rolling out? I had to stop it because I thought it was going to roll out in front of this car right here that goes by. So I decided to go back out once everything was clear, and then I re-engaged FSD beta. Now at this point, it did a pretty good job. It had to get into the right lane so it could turn right at the intersection. Now this is a very unusual intersection, because you'll see the main road is to our right here, and that road has a traffic light. But the direction I want to go, I'm going to be making a 45 degree turn, basically where that car is going, and that has a traffic light. So obviously that traffic light is red. So it wants to go behind that car, but it doesn't know what to do because there's no room. So it just continues to move forward. So again, that's a situation where there's only room for one car. And ideally what it should have done is stayed at that stop sign. And then once that car left, when the light turned green, then it should have turned in and then turned left into there. All right, so I said, all right, well, let me give this another shot. Let me try it from the other direction. So I put it back into FSD beta. It stopped at the stop. So now at this point, it needs to turn left and go where that first car went. But once it gets out of the stop sign and goes into the intersection, see that the left turn signal's on, but it doesn't even make an attempt to turn left. It just continues to move forward. So I said, okay, let's try one more time from the original direction and see what happens. And now this time, there is no other car in that spot. So there's room for us to move in there. So it's got the right turn signal. It has some hesitation. I think it's trying to figure out at this point what to do. And then it just starts kind of getting really aggressive with the turn, with these aggressive right turns. So I had to intervene and take control. So at this point, I took it out and I waited at the light, and then I just progressed and moved forward. So unfortunately, it just doesn't seem like this is something that the car at this point can handle. And it's really even confusing for humans. So bottom line, this right here could use some improvement. But as expected, it just didn't handle it well. Okay, so this next one I've used in regular autopilot many times, and every time as it goes into the sharp part of this turn, it actually goes to the left side of the road into the turning lane where that red car is. And actually, as it was turning, it felt like it was moving in the direction of that red car, and I had to take control. And now, as you can see, I put it back into FSD beta, And I thought, you know what? I'm going to turn around and I'm going to try this again. So here we are again. And once again, as I was going around that corner, there was another car there in that turning lane. But this time, I felt more confident that wasn't going to turn into that car. So for the first time, it didn't go into the left side of that road. And now it's taking a right turn to go into the road here. So I wanted to continue the video here because even though I have already communicated that it was successfully made that turn, didn't go to the left side of the road as autopilot's done before I had FSD beta, now I want to show you something that FSD beta has a problem with, at least my car has been having problems with. Now it does fine here, it goes into the turn, but this is a one lane row, right? So only one lane. Now eventually what's going to happen is we go around this bend, it is going to turn into two lanes. And this is where the car really starts having problems. It just can't make up its mind. Right lane, left lane. So at this point, it just went straight for the turning lane. It was going to go over the double yellow. So I took over and then I put it back into autopilot, or excuse me, FSD beta. Now this, I actually was very happy with the results because it is making a right turn after it crosses this intersection and you can't go straight from the lane on the right side. So it stayed on the left lane like it should have. Then as you can see, it thought ahead and moved into the right lane and now it's ready to make a right turn. So of course now it turned green and it is going to aggressively turn to the right. And I say that because if you've watched any other FSD beta videos on 10.2, most of them will say that right turns are pretty aggressive to the point where it takes off pretty quickly. So that is a positive. I think it did great with that last intersection and I'm very happy with it. Now this one was a bit of a different story. Now this is going from the highway into downtown and it was supposed to move straight. So the lane that it's in is the proper lane. It's great, we're doing great so far. But it actually starts to move into the left lane. And then it realizes, no wait, I'm supposed to be one lane over. So it kind of pulled one of those moves that people do actually a lot, where they change their minds and then they don't have room to move all the way into that lane. So until traffic actually moves, you're able to fully get into the lane. So it gets behind this Volkswagen and it starts moving forward. Now you can turn right from both of these lanes. That's what it wants to do. It wants to turn light. You see the turn signal's on. And all it has to do is follow this Volkswagen and go to the right. Watch what happens. It slows down, it hesitates, and next thing you know, it's moving forward. So it just missed the turn altogether. Like I said, it slowed down, it hesitated, and it moved in. Now, here's another thing I want to point out. This is two lanes, but you'll notice on the right side, there's a lot of room for parking. So it kind of veered over to the right, and then it kind of went back to the left. And you'll see that truck behind me on the screen there. See that truck? That truck was pretty close, but it was still safe. I didn't feel like I was gonna get rear-ended, but that was potentially a dangerous situation. So you need to be careful and watch what's behind you as well. But what I've noticed with FSD beta is it has a hard time with these wide lanes. It doesn't know if it should be in the center, if it doesn't know if it should be in the right, it doesn't know if it should be in the middle. All right, so I tried this again, where I was trying to get it to turn right behind that Volkswagen. Now this time, it actually made the right decision. So you can see it's staying in this lane. Now, I think partially the reason is because there is traffic and a line of traffic, and it couldn't really move over. But it's staying behind this Prius, which is what it needs to do. Now I think, and again, I don't know this from experience, but from what I'm experiencing is it has a difficult time turning right if there are two right lane turns. So it actually moves over into the right lane, which you can see that's actually a safe thing. It was okay. And it actually went over the solid line, which at that point you is kind of a point of no return. You get a turn from the other lane. So it moves very aggressively into all of this and it's like what? So I actually had to take over because I didn't quite know what it was doing, what it was going to do. So then I re-engaged FSD beta. Now this is just you slow down and take a left, but it actually treated it like a stop sign and then turned left. So you can kind of see how weird of a road this is. You take a right, then you take another left, kind of the 45 degree turns. And then of course it stopped here at the stoplight or traffic light. So that was kind of another negative experience. I'd like to keep trying this and see if it can improve over time. Now we do have a few roundabouts in this area, so we're going to go ahead and try a few roundabouts. These are some small, quaint little neighborhoods, and they've got these small little roundabouts. Now, what it did with this first one is it went in pretty aggressively, and you can see still moving it about, but you can see how it's slowing down there. It started to have a little bit of a problem. The wheel's kind of going back and forth, but it actually did go through the roundabout properly and got off on the right exit there. So, you know, kudos to FSD Beta for that. I think it did an okay job. It could have done better. It was pretty shaky, but it made it successfully and safely. All right, so I decided to go ahead and try that again. And you can see there's actually another roundabout coming up here. So what I can't remember. I'm going to have to kind of go through it. So it's saying to turn right, and I think it just had to go straight. But man, it was just booking it through it, and I just was nervous. So I had to kind of take over, and you know, I thought, all right, let's try this again. Let's try the exact same route that I just did right here, and let's see what happens. So as you can see, I started in the right spot here. And last time, as you know, of course you just saw it, it was successful. It was a little shaky, but it was successful and it made it safely. Now here's what's interesting, is it's kind of taking the same route it did last time, and it starts kind of going over that yellow line, and then it wants to turn left, and it can't quite make it, and then it actually turns right and goes straight. That's not the direction it was supposed to go. It was supposed to go where it went last time. So at least in the roundabouts here, it seems to have a bit of a problem. So at this point I thought, all right, I'm just gonna go home. So what I did is I went through this, and you can see that it's going through this roundabout. Now the thing that made me nervous about these roundabouts is that it's yield. No one has to technically stop, it's yield. And sometimes it was going into these roundabouts quite aggressively, and I did have to take control because it was moving in too fast, and you couldn't really see if people were coming. Now here, you can see, and you're probably thinking, wow, it's moving close to those cars. It is, it was moving close to those cars. This is another situation where we're in a residential road, a wide, wet residential road to allow for parking, but there's no center line. So the car, I just don't know if it knows what to do. So it's almost right there in the middle of the road. So if another car was coming, there's a chance I may have had to take over and kind of veered off a little bit more to the right. But there you can kind of see kind of a tar line. That's acting as a line for the car. So it stopped successfully here. We were the first ones at the stop sign. So, you know, legally it was able to go first, and so I think it did a great job here at this stop sign. And this one is another kind of one of those residential roads, but you see now it's doing better because we have a center strip in the road. If we have the painted lines, Tesla FSD Beta does a great job, but without the lines, there seems to be a bit of a problem. There needs to be some work there. Now here we had a little bit of a problem. See this truck here, it was stopped. It was taking a good portion of the lane. I wasn't sure what it was doing. There's an oncoming car. This was tight. And I think it would have been just fine, but I was uncomfortable. And I think with time, I'll be more comfortable with maneuvers like this. But for now, I had to take over. Okay, so as we start pulling up into this intersection, of course, we've got a red light. And what I noticed is at first, it stopped pretty far behind the line. You see how it's kind of slowly creeping, but then it turns green and it's like, okay, I don't need to really worry anymore and I'm just gonna go. And it turned right on the green as it should have. And here, this is pretty typical. We've got all the line markings on the road, so it's moving very smoothly, making some good turns here. And what I was noticing at this point is that there was a car behind me that was driving pretty aggressively. It was not quite tailgating me, but it was kind of right there on my tail. So upcoming here is a left turn, and I think it did an okay job here. What it does is I think it's waiting for that break in the line to go into that left turning lane. Now the car behind me was already in the left turning lane, so I had to kind of pull in front of it. But that's fine. Again, that was a legal move, and that was okay, and that was a safe thing. So now we're getting ready to make a left turn. Nothing exciting here. It did it successfully. Made this left turn. Did it quite a good job, actually. So I was happy with this left turn. Pretty smooth. Not terribly aggressive as I've experienced before. And it's kind of merging into this lane here perfectly. No ping-ponging back and forth. So it did a great job here. Now, as we advance forward into this video, there is a point. Now, in fact, it's not too far up ahead of here. There was a warning signal that I had received. And I received a warning signal, but I wasn't sure what it was for. And after I looked back at this video, I didn't see anything pop up on the screen. So I'm just going to kind of hold it here so you can hear the signal, and then we'll kind of discuss from there. Now, I think it was because it was coming over this hill and it saw that truck and it kind of freaked out, but there was no visual warning. It was just that audible alert. So I'm not exactly sure. Maybe it was just saying, hey, be aware there's a truck coming over that bend here. Now, the turn to the right is coming up, but not this first one. And I've used this in autopilot before and have never had problems before. It just keeps going straight. But for some reason, it went into the turning lane. Now, there was a car, remember, behind me that was driving aggressively? So I had to take control here because I think it wanted to go back into the road that I was on. So I took over here. Now I'm back into this road. And actually, this was another opportunity for me to try a roundabout. So let's take a look at this. There's a roundabout at the end of this road, and I thought I would give it a try. Okay, so we're approaching the roundabout. It's yield, and this makes me feel better that it's kind of taking its time doing this and yielding, actually, and slowing down to see if there are any other cars coming. Kind of came to a complete stop here for no reason. There were no other cars in this roundabout. And it did good. It knew which one it was supposed to get off at in the exit here, and it did fine. So other than that one stop at the very beginning, I was very happy with that roundabout because number one, it slowed down and yielded and checked for traffic. And other than that one stop, it did a great job going around that roundabout. Now, I got back to this and I was taking a right. Now again, this is all about comfort level. I'm still not 100% comfortable. So it was creeping out and it felt like it was ready to go, and I had to take control because you can see a car goes by. I was just concerned that it was gonna go. So I took over. So now I'm, of course, getting back on this road, and this is the road that I was originally supposed to be on. I wasn't even supposed to take that detour to that roundabout. So now we're going down this road, and at this point, it's pretty much status quo. It made a right turn perfectly. It went into my neighborhood and everything was fine. All right, so you made it through my boring video of me just kind of going through, driving through traffic. But what's not so boring about this is the fact that the car is driving, right? It's making decisions and it's making very quick decisions and computing data. And there are times when it just doesn't quite know what to do. And I get that. I understand that. And that's why this is... That's why it doesn't say just FSD in the video here. That's why my graphic right here doesn't say FSD 10.2. It says FSD beta. We're in beta form, which means it's still learning. And it's up to people like me and everyone else who has FSD beta to help Tesla get this better. So that's what we're doing here. So what these videos are to do to kind of help you see what the car is capable of, and as we start getting more and more updates, if we start to see improvement. And that's what we can do on these little macro scales, such as my little macro scale here, see if it starts improving on some of the things that had problems here. So what we have to keep in mind is that this is the first time the car most likely has driven on any of these roads, and it's just putting it into its database as far as what needs to be done to improve. And of course, any major mistakes, I'm able to push that feedback button. It goes to Tesla. Tesla also sent me an email for me to email them information on any kind of feedback as well. And that's something I plan on doing to kind of help them improve. So that is it for now. Overall, I'm still impressed and I'm still happy with FSD beta, and I'm happy with the progress it's made over the last year since the first initial beta testers kind of started getting this going. And I think that they have done a fantastic job in not only keeping us informed with their videos, but also keeping Tesla informed and giving them the data that they need. And now that more people are starting to get this and it's rolling out to more and more people, I think we're going to start to see improvements, much better improvements, and improvements much faster as they're going to be getting a lot more data. So that's going to do it for this video. I'm not going to be making one every day, but my plan is, as I mentioned, is anytime I drive with FSD beta, I'm going to have the camera rolling and I'm just going to kind of put it into my bag of videos and we'll kind of go through them. And I'm still working on the best way to present this. I don't know if it's best to see the wheel as it's moving. I don't know if it's best to just see the road and the screen. You let me know in the comment section below. Do you like seeing the wheel? Do you like seeing it move and have maybe some of the reaction? Do you like just seeing the screen and the road? Because I was also thinking about putting a GoPro. I've got a license plate holder that I can put a GoPro on. So I was thinking maybe putting one on the bumper. So I'm still playing around with those ideas, but let me know what you like in the comment section below as far as the best way to present it. Is what I've done here, the corner of the screen with the visualizations and the map, and of course the bigger screen, the road. But I try to not keep it too busy because we don't want to keep it too busy. Overall, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I should have another one probably coming out in the next couple of days. So until then, you know the drill. Like, subscribe, and stay positively charged.